फैक्ट इन इशू एंड रेलेवेंट फैक्ट्स. फर्स्ट वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड देम थ्रू एन एग्जाम्पल. सपोज दिस इज कालू एंड दिस इज नीलू. देयर इज एलिगेशन ऑन कालू दैट ही हैज किल्ड नीलू. सो द मेन क्वेश्चन हेयर इज वेदर कालू हैज किल्ड नीलू और नॉट. सो टू सॉल्व दिस मेन क्वेश्चन वी विल टेक द हेल्प ऑफ सम प्रूफ्स, सम फैक्ट्स. फर्स्ट प्रूफ इज दैट द वेपन यूज टू किल नीलू इट वॉज फाउंड इन कालूज हाउस. दिस प्रूफ, दिस फैक्ट इंक्रीज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट यस मे बी कालू हैज किल्ड नीलू. द प्रोबेबिलिटी इज हाई. दिस फैक्ट हेल्प्स टू सॉल्व द मेन क्वेश्चन बट इट डजेंट डायरेक्टली आंसर द मेन क्वेश्चन. इफ द गन इज फाउंड इज इन कालूज हाउस इट डजेंट डायरेक्टली आंसर दैट कालू हैज किल्ड नीलू. मे बी द मर्डरर हैज थ्रोन द वेपन इन कालूज हाउस. सो इट ओनली हेल्प्स टू सॉल्व द मेन क्वेश्चन बट डजेंट डायरेक्टली आंसर द मेन क्वेश्चन. सेकेंड फैक्ट इज दैट समवन सॉ कालू, अ पर्सन लुकिंग लाइक कालू कमिंग आउट ऑफ नीलूज हाउस एट द नाइट ऑफ द मर्डर. सो दिस प्रूफ ऑल्सो इंक्रीज द प्रोबेबिलिटी पॉसिबिलिटी दैट मे बी कालू हैज किल्ड नीलू बट इट डजेंट डायरेक्टली आंसर द क्वेश्चन बिकॉज दिस पर्सन मे बी समवन एल्स हु लुक्स लाइक कालू. नेक्स्ट प्रूफ इज दैट द डे बिफोर नीलू वॉज किल्ड कालू एंड नीलू हैड अ हीटेड आर्ग्यूमेंट. सो मे बी कालू हैज किल्ड नीलू इन रेज. सो दिस प्रूफ दिस फैक्ट इंक्रीज द पॉसिबिलिटी दैट कालू हैज मे बी हैज किल्ड नीलू. सो बट दिस ऑल्सो डजेंट डायरेक्टली आंसर द क्वेश्चन. मे बी दे आर गुड फ्रेंड्स एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ हीटेड आर्ग्यूमेंट्स आर नॉर्मल बिटवीन देम. सो ऑल दीज फैक्ट्स, ऑल दीज प्रूफ्स, दे हेल्प सॉल्व द मेन प्रॉब्लम, द मेन क्वेश्चन बट दे डोंट डायरेक्टली आंसर द मेन क्वेश्चन. द मेन क्वेश्चन हेयर वॉज दैट whether Kalu has killed Nilu, it is true or false. This main question is known as fact in issue or topic. This is the main question that Kalu has killed Nilu or not. This is the fact in issue. This is the fact in dispute. It is true or not. This is the main question. This is the main fact, or we can say this is the principal fact. And all the facts that help to solve the main question, the fact in issue, these facts are known as relevant facts. They help to solve the main question. These relevant facts help the court to understand the case, to understand the main question, to solve the main question. They help the court to reach a decision. I hope you have understood what is fact in issue and relevant facts. Differences between them. Fact in issue. It is the main fact or question that the court must decide. Relevant fact. These are the facts that help the court to understand or prove the fact in issue. It is not the main fact itself. They are not main fact itself, but they help the court to prove or understand the fact in issue. Next point here. Deciding the fact in issue leads to the final verdict of the case. It proves or disproves right or liability. When the fact in issue is decided, it leads to the final verdict of the case. Like in above example, if the fact in issue, that is whether Kalu killed Nilu or not, if it is decided, it will give the final verdict. It will lead to the final verdict. If it is true, then Kalu will get punishment. If it is false, then he will not get punishment. Relevant fact. They help the court to reach a decision, but do not determine the outcome by themselves. Relevant fact only help the court to reach a decision, but they don't themselves determine any outcome. They don't themselves give any decision. Like in above example, all these facts, they are not in themselves capable of giving any outcome, determining any outcome. They only help the court to reach a decision. Next point, fact in issue, they are directly related to the dispute between the parties. And relevant fact, they are indirectly related. They provide context evidence for the fact in issue. Like in above example, all these were evidence for the main question, that is fact in issue. fact an issue, it is asserted by one party and denied by other party. Like in above example, the one party that is asserting, that is Nilu, Nilu is dead now. Nilu's party is asserting that Kalu has killed Nilu, and the Kalu's party will deny it. And what is relevant fact? It is the basis of inferences used to make conclusion about fact in issue. Suppose we reach a conclusion that yes, Kalu has killed Nilu. So the basis of the inferences on which we have made this conclusion, the relevant facts are those bases. Here, the relevant facts, these are the basis on which we can make the inference that yes, Kalu has killed Nilu. We have reached this conclusion. These were differences. Now first we will see fact in issue. Its meaning, it is the main question or the main point that the courts needs to decide in a case. It is the central fact that is being disputed or argued about. It is asserted by one party and denied by the other party. The court's decision depends on whether the fact is proven to be true or false. Its adjudication results in disposal of the case. If the fact in issue, it's come to be true or false, the court's decision will depend on it. Like in above example, if it's true, Kalu will get punishment. If it's false, Kalu will not get punishment. And when fact in issue, it's adjudicated, it's solved, then the case is disposed of. It's complete. The definition of fact in issue, it is given in section 21G of Bharatiya Sakshi Adhiniyam. Here it says, it means and include any fact which either by itself or in connection with other facts goes on to prove or disprove the existence, non-existence, nature or extent of any right, liability or disability asserted by one party in a suit or proceeding and denied by the other. In it, it says, in simple words, we can say, suppose there is a property on which one party asserts its right. It says, I have right in this property. One party is asserting, another party is denying it, that he doesn't have this any right in this property. So the fact in issue will be whether this party has the right or not in this property. So this fact in issue will prove or disprove the existence of this right. If it is decided by relevant facts like registry, papers in possession, that this party is not the owner of this property, then this right will be proved or disproved. Its existence will be proved or disproved. You have to memorize this definition if you want to write the exact definition in the exam. Relevant facts. Its meaning. These are the facts or information that helps the court to understand or decide the main question or fact in issue in a case. They are connected to the fact in issue in some way, but are not the main issue themselves. They provide context, support and explanation to the main question, but are not themselves the main issue being disputed. Relevant facts make it easier for the court to figure out the truth of the case. This was the meaning of relevant facts. The definition is given in section 21K of Bharatiya Sakshi Adhiniyam. It says, when one fact is connected to the other fact in any of the ways referred to in the provisions of this act relating to relevancy of facts. This definition given in section 21K does not give a clear definition of relevant facts, but only states that one fact is relevant to another when one is connected to the other in the manner provided under section 4 to 50 of the act. In section 4 to 50 of Bharatiya Sakshi Adhiniyam, there are provisions which provides the manner in which a fact can be said relevant fact or not. So if a fact comes under these provisions, then it will be relevant, otherwise it is not relevant. This definition says only this. It is not a clear definition of relevant fact. For clarity, you can see the meaning of relevant facts. Next point, section 3 of Bharatiya Sakshi Adhiniyam, it says, in any suit or proceeding, evidence may be given of fact in issue or relevant facts and of no others. So you can give evidence of only fact in issue and relevant facts. Only these are admissible. Any other type of facts, if you give evidence of any other type of facts, it will not be admitted. The court will not admit it. Examples we have seen, murder case, Kalu Nilu. In it, the fact in issue, the main question was whether Kalu killed Nilu or not. The relevant facts were, other connected facts were, like first was motive. Kalu and Nilu had a heated argument a day before Nilu was killed. This suggests Kalu might have had a reason to harm Nilu. Second was weapon. The gun used in the murder was found in Kalu's house. This connects Kalu to the crime weapon. Next was witnesses. A neighbor saw someone who looked like Kalu leaving Nilu's house at night. This strengthens the suspicion. All these relevant facts help to understand the main question. These facts help the court understand whether Kalu could have committed the murder or not. These facts don't directly answer the main question, but they help the court understand what happened and decide the main question. Another example, you can write contract breach case. Suppose there is one person, Rohan. He made a contract with some client that he will deliver some goods in 10 days, and he could not deliver the goods in 10 days, so the client has alleged that Rohan has breached the contract. The fact in issue, the main question here is, did Rohan break the contract by not delivering the products on time? The relevant facts here will be, the other connected facts will be, first maybe factory closure. Rohan's factory was closed because of a government lockdown. This might explain why he couldn't deliver the products on time. Suppose there was a government lockdown, due to it Rohan's factory was closed, so he could not deliver the goods. From this fact, there is high probability that Rohan has not breached the contract. It was due to government lockdown. Next is past behavior. In the past, Rohan has delivered goods late before. This could show that maybe Rohan is often late and it is his fault. This fact says that in previous times also Rohan has delivered the goods lately, so maybe he is at fault. Through this fact there is high possibility or probability that Rohan has breached the contract. Next relevant fact is extension agreement. Rohan and his client had a WhatsApp exchange where the client agreed to give Rohan more time. This is important because if there was an agreement for more time, he didn't actually break the contract. Suppose Rohan and his client, they had a chat on WhatsApp. On that chat, the client extended the time of delivery. He said, instead of 10 days, you can deliver it in 15 days. So from this chat, from this relevant fact, there is high probability that Rohan has not breached the contract. He was working according to the WhatsApp chat. So all these facts help the court understand whether Rohan really did breach the contract by delivering late or if there were good reasons for it. These facts don't answer the main question directly, but they help the court to decide. This was your fact in issue and relevant facts in Bharatiya Sakshya Adhiniyam. For quick revision, if you want PDF file of the notes, they are available at www.lockup.com.